I've never met a tailor before, but I know you ain't one.
Come with me. Come on. What do you see? I see a young man with potential.
Pull the hook on your left.
Oh, yes. Very nice. What does this do? Electrocute you?
Don't be ridiculous. It's a hand grenade.
Shut up.
So, guys, I'm loving the song. I'm really enjoying it. I want to know how you got involved in this movie. And would you like to be spies yourselves? Maybe you're going to get into that game after this song?
We may already be spies.
Ooh, undercover.
Never know.
Yeah, you know where you live.
We got involved through Matthew Vaughan, who's the director. We've done a couple of movies with him before. Called us in, said, we'll play the movie. We loved the movie. We watched it. It was probably April, May. Yeah. It was early on. They didn't have any special effects at that point. So we watched it, loved it. Most of the score was done, which was nice to hear. And we went away and spent a couple of days in our studio and came up with Get Ready For It.
And of course, the video is brilliant as well. You're getting tailored, you're getting all the suits, but you guys are well used to wearing suits. You're kind of the king of suits at this point.
I've never had a suit fitted.
Tailored, really? Tailored,
never.
Yeah, usually, I've seen you guys, you wear suits a lot.
So I know, but none of them fit us.
Yeah. They've all got staples at the back.
You're true, it is.
So they have decency to actually give you the suit then, and like to keep after that?
Oh, it's upstairs.
Oh, really?
Yeah, we've got them. Our Kingsman suits are upstairs waiting for us. I don't know if I could ever wear it. I might just look at it.
Yeah. I'm putting mine in a glass case. Yeah. they're beautiful suits, though. Yeah. I mean, incredible. To have something really fitted to your body, it's brilliant.
Yeah. And your album 3, of course, went to number 1. You must have been delighted. I mean, were you thrilled when you heard the news?
Yeah. I mean, it's on many levels. When you're making anything, when you're making a record, you want people to hear it. That's always my thing. I hope people are going to get a chance to hear it. And when you know that a record has done well and people have gone out and supported it, then I think, oh, then you start thinking, oh, I hope they like it. And,
yeah.
You know, so it's just great for us. We've got a big tour next year and that we're working towards now. With
this year?
Oh, God, this year in 2015. Yeah. You're coming to the 3 Arena in Dublin as
well. We've got a big tour. We've got a big tour this year coming up in a few months. So we started work on that, and it's just for me, it's enjoyable to be here today, and tomorrow we've got tour meetings, and the next day we're in the studio writing, and it's exciting. It's an amazing, you know, thing to be a part of.
And a new experience performing as a 3-piece, because I saw you when you played at X Factor as in the audience, and you were brilliant. Yeah, it was brilliant. I thought you were really good. So are you enjoying performing as a 3-piece? How different, is it different in a good way, or how are you feeling about it?
Well, I think it's something we get used to more and more every day, to be honest with you. We went from a 4 to a 5, which was a new shift, and now we're down to a 3. So it's been a while since it's actually been quite settled, you know, within the band. So, but I think we all kind of know ourselves well enough to know what we enjoy doing and how we want to portray a song or, you know, and it's different for different songs. But it's, I think it's, where was I going to go with this? I've totally forgotten that.
You're going great.
I had an end to it.
So is it an open door with Take That, in that people can come in and, do you know, kind of, will anybody ever come back, or is it like, you're gone, see you later now, or what's the story for?
No, it's an open door. It's you know, if Jason wants to come back next year, that's totally cool. Or this year, should I say. If Robbie wants to come back, it's an open door. And I think going back to the album being number 1 as well, I mean, with Jason leaving and us being a 3, obviously it was very special for it to go to number 1 and for the tour to sell out, and, you know, after Jason leaving, because we didn't know what was going to happen. We didn't know whether the supporters and fans would want us to carry on as a 3.
Yeah,
but luckily, you know, they did, and we had so much support of them. It was unbelievable.
I was going to say, as well, since our last tour as well, we've, you know, it's 4 years on, we've grown and a bit older. So I think naturally you kind of shape changes, doesn't it, as you're going through life. When we were 20, we were dancing to every song at 100 miles an hour. So, you know, there's lots of factors to take in, I think, as when we talk about how we want to perform and how we're feeling about the whole thing.
Yeah.
I thought it was going to be better than that.
I thought it was, yeah. I know, it was a bit of a letdown in the end.
It was a big build-up.
Big build-up. Yeah.
We mentioned X Factor earlier on. Are you still watching it, Gary? Would you ever go back? Do you miss being a judge and judging people?
Judge people all day.
Do you? Yeah. We all do. Tell me, don't be an X Factor
judge. I've got a real good view on you.
Good, I hope.
I loved it. I loved watching it last year. I didn't miss being on it, if I'm honest, because sort of like getting the last 10 weekends to yourself before Christmas is always great. But I enjoyed watching it, and I thought the final was great, actually.
Yeah. Brilliant. Well, listen, guys, pleasure to talk to you. Congratulations on the single and the album. Love it. Cheers.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
We're here to enhance your skills, test you to the limit.
You need to solve problems under pressure, like what to do when one of your group has no parachute.
Interested?
Manners maketh man.
I have trouble understanding you people sometimes. You all talk so funny.